in there with Martin, ready to scrap, ready to fight, and finish him.
Oh my God, unbelievable start! Oh, Diego's up!
I'm gonna stay in his face. I'm gonna keep the pressure on him. I'm not backing off. And prove to the world I'm the real number one contender.
We're in the main event because we come to fight. We're in there to finish the other guy, so this is gonna be action-packed.
Good straight line, he finishes.
I'm gonna be right there, meet him in the middle.
Big shot by Kampmann. The hitman looking to finish the fight.
His biggest worry should be getting knocked the out.
Oh, Kampmann!
There's the answer, though.
I don't care what Martin Kampmann's done to prepare for this fight. My confidence is ultra high right now. I'm gonna be ready to fight in any position in this fight. Plan on making another statement.
What a performance!
I'm ready. This victory's mine.
I'm ready for whatever he brings.
Armin guillotine! He's out! He's out!
So, bring it.
Gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. Our three judges join this contest at Octagon Sidearm. Chris Lee, Sal D'Amato, and William Mattingly. And the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, from the KFC Young Center in Louisville, Kentucky, introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist with a professional record, 17 wins, 4 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 171 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Martin the Hitman Kampmann! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding professional record, 24 wins, 4 losses. Standing 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 171 pounds. Fighting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the Ultimate Fighter Season 1 winner, Diego Sanchez!
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We're going to have a clean fight. Touch gloves, make it official.
I love it.
He touched gloves to the chest.
Kampmann and Sanchez.
Great fight. Ready. Good.
Wait. White trunks for the southpaw. The Ultimate Fighter winner, Diego Sanchez. Black trunks for Martin Kampmann. Should be advantage of the strike. Sanchez should be the much better wrestler. Watch out, the jab for his punches. Young fighters can really learn from watching this guy. Non-title fight, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds, body shot.
Diego has power in his hands, knocked out Joe Riggs with one punch. And it was that punch, that right hook.
Sanchez, winner of 5 of his last 7 fights, opened his MMA career, winning his first 19 fights.
Clean straight right, yep. Very clean.
Take out attack by Diego. And that straight right against the southpaw can be effective.
Yeah, He's working this single and trying very hard, but Kampmann does an excellent job of stuffing it, keeping going against the cage, and he makes it even Kampmann. It seems by Kampmann. That was brilliant. Brilliant takedown defense there by Kampmann.
Ever evolving in the octagon. Our MMA fighters. Martin Kampmann, no exception. Caught him with another left hand.
We're halfway through this round and Diego is already busted up.
Kampmann is quietly lethal.
He's just so technical in everything he does. Both his ground and his stamina and his ability to avoid those takedowns. I mean, everything he does is perfect.
Looking for the finish.
No, nice knee. Beautifully timed. Look how easy he's stuffing these takedowns.
Diego went for the single and he ate a knee on the way in.
I mean, it just looks like he's just much better.
Again with the
keeping that, keeping the fight standing than Diego expected. And Diego's bleeding quite a bit out of his mouth by right? He eats another punch. Oh man, he's getting lit up.
Straight right again. And a nice sprawl.
Diego just missed with a right hand there. That's what Diego's got to do. He's got to turn this into a dog fight. He's bleeding really badly out of his mouth, Mike. I don't know what's going on there. That's quite a lot of blood.
Lead right hook.
It's dripping out of his mouth while he's bleeding, rather.
Ready, go.
Kampmann, former Danish Thai boxing champion, as we mentioned earlier.
Diego landed there.
One minute. Here in the first round for Martin Kampmann.
Going off the shorts.
And Martin saying that Diego's grabbing his shorts.
Second fight at 170 for Kampmann.
Stops that takedown attempt as well. Gets him out of the knee. Wow, Diego's bleeding.
Yeah, a big cut on the bridge of his nose, Joe.
Yeah, his whole face is a bloody mess right now. And you see the blood in the chest.
Great first round for the Danes.
And here we see the replay. Look at that. Diego winds up with a punch, and Martin throws it crisp and clean and catches him before his shot can get through. And here he's picking him apart. Jab, straight right, and look the way he's throwing these punches. That's the most important thing. They're coming in a straight line, and they're coming very short, and that's why they're landing.
Will it be more the same? Anxious moments in the corner of Sanchez after such a dynamic first round.
What they said is they want to take down attempts every time they lock up. They want him to switch single double switch. Nice needle leg by Diego.
Wrestling is his foundation. Began wrestling at age 12.
We can make Martin Kampmann work. When he's standing out here like this, he's getting picked apart.
1, 2, 3, there it is. Sanchez looking to get through on his own jab.
can be a problem. And he loves that lead uppercut to Sanchez. And he just missed with it a second ago.
He's just technically not at the same level or near it as Martin Kampmann is.
And then Kampmann starts stuffing some takedowns, and it becomes the hitman's fight, right? Under the right eye is damaged. Eight wins at 170 in the UFC career of Sanchez.
Another takedown attempt. See Greg Jackson. Greg wants to drop it down.
He runs the risk of getting tagged hard. He's at the
three times in that round,
which was the huge difference between round one and round two. Kampmann stayed technical, stayed superior in his attack, and avoided the slugfest. What will we see in the final 5 minutes? Close fight, main event of the evening.
Job stuffing it. He's looking for a knee and lands it. Nice.
A minute into the third and final round.
Martin's taking some big deep breaths, Mike. And his punches are coming slower.
Sanchez delivered some punishment in the second round.
You see him early a minute in. You see him moving around and breathing out of his mouth.
Including some shots to the body. That shot early to the body in the third took some of the wind back. Continue to battle.
Another damn attack. Stopped every single one of them and easy. And now he's looking for the hands to come out of the line. Nice kick to the
choice of strikes by Kampmann.
Push, Diego! Take it down, Diego! Get it down! You got to push!
I think they need to change that. Push. I think if he knees down, that's a good point. But I think hands down, I think that's silly. Because guys are doing it just to avoid being on you.
Absolutely.
You see how they play the game. You said it would be on top of the
game. Midway point of the third and final round.
Diego is carrying his punch into this round better than Mark Kampmann is. Mark is tired.
Continuously back to the top.
put some pictures of himself tomorrow, and I can't wait to see him.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. All three judges score this contest 29-28, declaring the winner by unanimous decision,
controlling the end of the fight.
Well, you also tagged him with some good shots when you got him finally up against the cage into that second round. You finally got him to get his back up against the cage, and it seemed like you landed some good shots there as well.
You know what? I just give all the glory to Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. That's why I'm in here. And hey, Louisville, I love you guys, man. I thank you guys. This place is awesome. Come out here, Louisville. You guys are an awesome state, an awesome city. Comes here again. Thank you very much.
Diego, you're known as a ferocious fighter with tremendous heart. You came out and you proved that tonight. Congratulations.
Hey, this is one for my son now, Ivan, who's homesick. I love you, Ivan.
All right, I'm here with Martin. Martin, we were just going to interview the winner, but there's so much controversy here. So many people are booing, and I'm coming to you too. Did you think you won the fight?
Yes, I did. I thought I won the fight.
It looked to me round and probably the second. Did you think that he did enough in the third? Were you worried at all?
I think I won all three rounds, but definitely Diego caught him with some good shots as well. But you know, I think look at his face. I mean, I got a little cut too, but no, I definitely feel I won the fight. He was throwing a lot of flurries, but most of it wasn't landing. I feel I was landing way more with cleaner shots.
And, you caught him with some tremendous shots in the first round. Were you surprised that you weren't able to put him away?
You know, Diego's a tough warrior, and I know he's going to keep going, but I'm very disappointed now. I can't put words on this. I really thought I won the fight.
I you know what? I feel you, and I know where you're coming from, and it was a very, very close fight.
I think I broke my hand, too.
We were thinking that in the third round as well.
Yeah, I think I broke my hand. I was kind of holding again. I couldn't throw my right hand, but I still think I won the fight hands down.
Well, I thought you won it coming into the third round as well, and I think a lot of the people here thought you won it as well. Look, it was a great fight. You performed very well. Tremendous fight, very entertaining, and we look forward to seeing you again. Martin Kampmann, ladies and gentlemen.
One of the most ferocious and